Welcome to a video on geometric sequences. The goals of this video are to determine the nth term of a geometric sequence, determine the common ratio of a geometric sequence, and also to determine the formula for a geometric sequence. So let's go ahead and get started. A geometric sequence is a sequence that has a pattern of multiplying by a constant to determine consecutive terms. We say geometric sequences have a common ratio. So if we take a look at this sequence below, if we look for a pattern, we'll see that we multiply the first term by 3 to get the second term, and that pattern is the same to go from the second term to the third term, it's times 3, and to go from the third to the fourth, it's also times 3, and so on. So this is the pattern that we're talking about when we say we're multiplying by a constant to determine consecutive terms. This tells us that our common ratio, or r, is equal to 3. We can also calculate it by taking any term in the sequence and dividing by the term before it. And the way we express that is a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1. So if we use a sub 2, we divide by a sub 1. Negative 6 divided by negative 2 is equal to positive 3. And it's also true that if we took this term, we'd have the same common ratio, negative 54. Divided by negative 18 is still equal to positive 3. This next formula says that we can find any term in the sequence if we take the first term, a sub 1, and multiply it by r raised to the power of n minus 1. If you take a look at the third term here, to get negative 18, we multiplied the first term, negative 2, by 2 factors of 3. So to get the third term, we multiplied the first term by r twice, or n minus 1 times. To get the fourth term, we multiply the first term times 3 to the power of 1, 2, 3, which again is n minus 1. And this last formula just states that if we want, let's say, a sub 5, we can find it by multiplying a sub 5 minus 1, or a sub 4, times r. So to find any term, we can multiply the term before it times r. Let's take a look at some problems. A sequence is a function, so therefore it has a domain and a range. The values of n represent the domain, and the terms in the sequence represent the range. So this is a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, a sub 4, and a sub 5. That's telling us that n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in this sequence. So the domain would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the range are the actual elements or numbers in the sequence. So negative 12, 6, negative 3, 3 halves, and negative 3 fourths represent the range. We normally write these in order from least to greatest, so we'll write this as negative 12, negative 3, negative 3 fourths, 3 halves, and 6. They also want us to find the common ratio, r. So what we can do is select any term in the sequence and then divide by the term before it. Let's go ahead and use a sub 3. So the common ratio, if we use a sub 3, we would divide by a sub 2. So we would have negative 3 divided by 6, which is equal to negative 1/2 for our common ratio. Okay, on this problem, we're given the formula for the geometric sequence, and we're asked to determine the first two terms and then the fifth term, and then also state the common ratio. So if we want to find a sub 1, a sub 2, and a sub 5, this is telling us the value of n to use. So if we want a sub 1, that means n is equal to 1. Well, 3 times 2 to the first, that would be equal to 6. A sub 2, that would be 3 times 2 to the power of 2 now. Well, 2 squared is 4. 4 times 3 would be 12. And then the fifth term, we would have 3 times 2 to the power of 5. Well, 2 to the fifth is equal to 32. 32 times 3 is equal to 96. So the sequence looks like this. We have 6, 12, then we have the third, the fourth term, the fifth term is 96, and so on. Now they also ask us to state the common ratio. Let's go ahead and use a sub 2. So the common ratio would be a sub 2 divided by the term before it, which is a sub 1. Well, 12 divided by 6 is equal to 2. Our common ratio is equal to 2. And what you'll notice looking back at the formula is 2 is the base which we raise to the power of n. And this will always be the case when we have a geometric sequence. The base will be our common ratio. And let's take a look at one more question. Here we're given a geometric sequence. We want to determine the formula and then also determine the sixth term. So if we go down here and take a look at our geometric formulas, here's the formula for a sub n, or the formula for this sequence. So we need to find two things, a sub 1 and r. Well, a sub 1 is straightforward, that's just the first term. A sub 1 is equal to 1/3. And then to find the common ratio, we need to select one term and divide by the term before it. Let's go ahead and use the second term. So the common ratio will be equal to a sub 2 divided by the term before it, or a sub 1. This will be 2/9 divided by 1/3. So let's go ahead and figure out what this would be. 2/9 divided by 1/3, remember, is the same as 2/9 times 3/1, and this does simplify. And the result is 2/3. So r is equal to 2/3. So we have all the information we need for the formula. We have a sub 1, and we have r. So the formula for this sequence will be a sub n equals a sub 1, which is 1/3, times r to the power of n minus 1, which would be 2/3. Power of n minus 1. And the last question was to determine the sixth term. So we want to find a sub 6. So we'll have 1/3 times 2/3 to the power of n minus 1, or 6 minus 1. That would be to the fifth power. So this will be 2 to the fifth times 1. This is going to be 3 to the fifth times another factor of 3 here. So we have 3 to the 6th. Well, 2 to the 5th is equal to 32. And 3 to the power of 6 would be the same as 3 to the 3rd times 3 to the 3rd, or 27 times 27. And that'll give us 729. So the 6th term is 32 over 729. And that'll do it for this video on geometric sequences. I hope you found it helpful.